I've decided to quit coffee for 2 weeks, and here is what happened. Hey, what's up? Greg here, the founder of Your Inception. Welcome to my channel. If you want to achieve limitless performance, then subscribe below to start your journey. Yeah, I decided to quit coffee for 2 weeks, and today I want to share this experience with you. I want to talk about what happened, why I did it, what are the benefits, the side effects you can expect from doing this courageous decision or making it. And at the end, I will tell you also, if you want to quit coffee as well, how to do it in the best way possible so you don't suffer from the side effects that come with it. So if you're ready, let's just begin. Now, I've been drinking coffee for the past probably like 7-8 years, something like that. And I really love coffee. I love the smell of it. I like the taste of it. I like experimenting with coffee. I make bulletproof coffee. I, you know, prepare it in different ways. I bought this cool espresso machine. I made different types of coffee, like Turkish way, like I like the Greece, how people do it in Greece, and so on. So I'm a big fan of drinking coffee. I'm not an expert, but yeah, I really love it. And one of the reasons I like it so much is because I really love the benefits that you can get from drinking coffee and because of the caffeine that coffee has. But recently I started noticing some very weird stuff going on with me. So after a couple of days of hard work, I gradually increased the amount of coffee I was drinking during the day. So I went from one coffee on Monday to probably 3-4 coffees on Thursday and Friday. And after a couple of weeks, actually after 2 weeks of doing that, what happened was I had a very severe crash, and this crash repeated like every 2 weeks approximately. So whenever I increased the dosage of coffee to 3-4 coffees per day, I actually noticed that my body was just shutting down. I got this, you know, severe crash. I had some severe side effects like brain fog, like jittery, like, you know, my heart was, you know, going wild. And at first I wasn't really sure this is connected to coffee, but then, you know, I experimented a bit. I tried different things. I optimized my daily habits and I figured out, yeah, it was probably the coffee making those issues. So as a consequence, I made this courageous decision and decided to quit drinking it for just 2 weeks and see what happens. Now, just before I tell you my experience, I just want to tell you that you probably know about it, but if you don't, coffee is a very powerful stimulant. It is the most widely used stimulant in the world. And while it is a very effective energy booster, it increases your attention, it increases your energy, and it provides a lot of antioxidants. At the same time, it can be quite dangerous if you overdrink it because you get dependent on it. And by doing that, I mean, you cannot start your day without a cup of coffee, and all of a sudden you're drinking 2, 3, 4, 5 cups of coffee per day. And then, you know, you're gonna get this massive crash that, you know, quite often people talk about. So yeah, you have to look at the caffeine that you get with coffee as a pretty strong stimulant. It's not just like, you know, a random thing that kind of makes you feel better, but it's quite a strong stimulant, so you have to be careful with it. So when I decided to quit coffee, I thought that was gonna be an easy task. I mean, what, like 2 weeks without coffee? That's like nothing. I can easily do it. And honestly, in the beginning, yeah, it was quite easy. Well, kind of. But then after 2-3 days without coffee, I mean, yeah, I start to feel like shit, you know? I couldn't focus. I was really unmotivated in the morning. I had no energy. Like, I usually had this routine in the morning, which included drinking a cup of coffee, but then, you know, there was no coffee anymore and I switched it to tea. Obviously, I put in this is one of my favorite cups, and I put tea in it to kind of trick my mind. Obviously, it didn't work. I mean, what did I expect? But anyway, yeah, I tried a lot of things, and after the first couple of days, I really, you know, wasn't feeling well. And I was starting to get worried, like, where is this leading to? And why am I so dependent to coffee? I mean, that's insane. I wasn't aware of that before. But after a couple of days, so it was, I think, after a week or something, yeah, there were all the problems were gone, basically. When I woke up, I felt very motivated. I felt energized. I kind of didn't miss my... I mean, honestly, I missed my cup of coffee because of the taste and the smell, but I felt pretty good without it. I was definitely much more energized. Also during the day, I felt much more energized. Also like after like eating a meal or something, you know, I didn't have this typical need for a coffee, and that was quite encouraging basically. I was quite positively surprised. So after like 7 to 10 days, all the side effects like the jittery, the brain fog, the lack of motivation and energy were gone, and I felt extremely well. And you know, from day to day, after like 15 days, and you know, just before I drank my first cup of coffee again, I was just feeling better and better and better, and I was really shocked that you can feel so good even without, you know, your daily caffeine dose. So yeah, and after the 20-day period, I didn't need my coffee anymore. I didn't even think about it. When I passed some coffee shops, yeah, of course I saw people drinking coffee, I smelled it, and I you know, I some of the memories got back. But apart from that, you know, I really didn't need it to be focused, to have energy, to be in a great mood. Yeah, that was quite a positive thing. So look, if you are suffering right now, this moment, like if you think you're dependent to drinking coffee, if you cannot start working in the morning without your cup of coffee, then you probably are dependent. And in this case, I would definitely recommend you making a 2-week detox from caffeine. Not because coffee is harming you in any way, like it's not really harmful, but you're gonna feel so much better if you can do this. Now, the best way to do it, that's in my opinion, is that you find an alternative to drinking coffee. Something that will not smell and look like coffee, but it will provide some of the benefits that coffee provides without the side effects. In my opinion, the best option is drinking yerba mate tea. You can find more information below about this amazing South American tea. I switched to it like immediately. I drank like 2 to 3 cups of yerba mate every day. It does contain some caffeine, so keep that in mind, but very low amount. And after like 1 week, I switched to green tea. I had a pretty strong green tea, which again, it contains a little bit of caffeine, but like a very little amount, so there's nothing to worry about. And you know, if you do this, what's gonna happen is, yeah, you can expect to have a mild crash at the beginning. This crash will probably include some kind of brain fog, some kind of loss of motivation. You won't be in such a good mood in the morning, but as soon as you change this, as soon as your body kind of gets rid of, you know, all the caffeine that's hiding in it, what's gonna happen is you'll regain your energy, you'll regain your focus, you'll regain your motivation. And as soon as you do this, as soon as you find like an alternative that you can drink in the morning that is part of your daily habit, your brain will get rewired. That's how I call it usually. And it will kind of figure out, okay, now when I drink this cup of tea, I need to perform. Before it was coffee, now it's tea, that's fine, okay, I can do it. So yeah, you should, you know, kind of feel much better in about a week, 10 days. Something like that. And what you're gonna figure out is, you know, with coffee you get a spike of energy and then the crash follows. If you drink bulletproof coffee, this is a coffee with MCT oil and some people put butter in it. I try to avoid butter, but anyway. So what happens is that you have constantly those spikes of energy and then crash follows, the spike and crash. After you kind of get rid of coffee for like 10, 15 days, you don't have the spikes, obviously, and there are no crashes, obviously, but your baseline of energy increases, okay? So you have more energy by default. At least that's what I feel, and I, you know, checked some other people doing the same thing, what were their experiences, and they kind of, you know, talked about exactly the same thing. Sure, you're gonna still miss, and if you love drinking coffee, I mean, you're gonna still miss the taste and the smell and stuff, and I'm not telling you to stop drinking coffee forever, but you know, just making such a detox every now and then can be very beneficial. By the way guys, if you like this video, please press the like button below. So the question is, what to do after 2 weeks of drinking no coffee? Well, it kind of depends on how you feel. Now, what I did is, I drink 1 cup of coffee per day during the week, so from Monday to Friday, and I try to avoid any kind of coffee during the weekend. That's kind of my strategy that I'm trying right now, and it works really well because I still get a lot of the benefits from drinking coffee, and the crashes that I usually got are like non-existent at this moment, especially if I add some MCT oil to it, so if I prepare the bulletproof coffee. So that's one thing you can do. So you can by detoxing your body, you can kind of decrease the amount of caffeine you will basically need in the future on a daily basis to operate on how you want to operate. So you can still drink your cup of coffee because you like the taste, obviously. And by avoiding coffee during the weekend, you kind of make, you know, this weekly detox. I would call it the weekend coffee detox, you know. And yeah, after a while, you will feel much better. You will have more focus, more energy. The spikes of energy won't be so, you know, it won't be so high. And you know, when the crash happens, it's gonna be pretty mild crash if it's going to happen. And I can imagine you can do this for weeks and weeks and even months, you know, without having to do a longer detox. So yeah, that's what you can do. And I think you're gonna be very happy about it once you go through it. So yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you for watching, guys. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to contact me. Don't forget to follow Your Inception on Facebook, Instagram, and I hope to see you soon, guys. Take care.